Hello and welcome to Excel is Simple. Today, we are going to make the simple and easy to use identity card creator, which you can use to quickly create print-ready identity cards for your team and can change the team members with just the click of a button like this. A link to download this template is available in the description below, but make sure to watch the video till the end so that you understand all the nitty-gritties of the tracker along with the relevant functions. So, let's get started and design this identity card from scratch. First of all, let's create a sheet which has the data of employees. So I'll go to this plus, click over here, a new tab has opened up. Let me call it employee data. Now here I'll add all the information that I want to be visible on the identity card. Employee code, name, age, blood group, contact number, and leave one space for the photograph. You can add any other info as well that you think is important to be displayed on the card. Now let's add some dummy data to this particular table. Let's now start adding the photographs. Now make sure that all the images are of the same size so that when the images appear on the cards, they look symmetrical, like what I have done in this particular example. So now what you can do is that you can insert the image in the first cell. So go to the cell, then from the insert ribbon, click on pictures and press picture from file. A new window pops up and now select the file from the folder and place it in the cell and press insert. When the file is inserted, you can size it and put it inside the cell. Make sure that you resize the cell as well and do not damage the aspect ratio of the image. Then what you can do is that you can resize the other cells as well so that their images can get into the cells perfectly. Now what you can do is that you can either go to each individual cell and repeat the exercise or else follow this simple trick. Make a copy of the image inserted in the first cell by using copy-paste shortcuts and then put this copy in the second cell. Then right-click on the second image and click Change Picture. Then select the relevant second picture and press insert. You will see that the image is replaced and the new image is exactly the size of the previous one. So now using this trick, we can add images to each and every required cell. Now that our data is complete, let's design the identity card. But before that, make sure that you're subscribed to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified every time a new video is uploaded. Now let's open a new tab and first of all make a template for the identity card. You will need to select the area in the sheet which looks like the same aspect ratio of the card. Let's say this area is what is my designated area for the card. I will add a thick box border to this area like this. Now I will color the top and bottom areas of the card with the brand colors of my company, school or shop. Let's say I've selected three rows from the top and now I'll go to fill color and fill the required color. Now let's say the required color is not available in the list, but you have it somewhere online or in a different file. As an example, let's say this blue of Best Buy is your brand color. So what you'll do is that in the fill color, select more colors. And then you'll see a color picker tool at the bottom of the window. Here, click on this tool. And you will see a zoomed window showing the precise color of the surface below. Now without clicking anywhere, go to the browser or the application where you have the brand color, hover to the place where you have the brand color and match it to the zoomed view that you see. Once you're sure, just make a click. Press OK and you will see that the color is added in the selected area of the card. Now go to the bottom section of the card and select the cells that you have to fill. This time when you go to the fill color button, you'll see that the color is there in the recent color section. Select the color and fill it. Next, we can just merge the cells at the top and the bottom sections so that any text added there is symmetrical. In the top section, add a logo of your company and the name of the company. In the bottom section, you can add your address and the website with the message, if found, please return to. Leave an area for the photograph and then below add the header information that has to be displayed, which is the employee ID, name, age, blood group, and the contact number. Now that my design is ready, what I'll do is that I'll add a drop-down for selecting the employee code or ID. Let me add the drop-down here outside. I'll call it Select Employee ID. And then here I'll put down the drop-down. For that, I'll go to the cell and select Data from the ribbon, select Data Validation, and a new window pops up. In the validation criteria, select List, and then go to the Source section. Now, without clicking anywhere, go to the Employee Data tab and select the first employee code. Then drag till the last employee is selected, like this, and check in the pop-up window Source section that the source is correct. Click OK and you'll be back in the Identity Card tab. The drop-down is there and you can see all the IDs are there in the list. Now here we'll be mostly using VLOOKUP functions. And as I've always advised, whenever you're using VLOOKUP function, make sure to use named ranges. So you can go back to the employee data and select the entire table. And let's say I call it ID. Coming back to the identity card, we'll start filling the information. First of all, let's select an ID for an employee from here. In the ID card area against employee ID, just put it equal to the drop-down list. For the name, it will be equal to VLOOKUP of employee ID, which is this cell, comma, the named range ID, comma. We know that the name is the second column, so it will be 2, 0 for the perfect match. Bracket close and enter. Just copy this formula and paste it in all the other three cells. Depending on the column number of the named range, which is ID, you can select the column index number in each formula. Like age is 3, blood group is 4, and contact number is 5. So now we have all this information and you can format the contact number to reflect area code in brackets. So what we are going to do is that we'll put the entire VLOOKUP formula inside a text function for the contact number like this. Let me cut it, Control X, then do text of this particular formula, comma, code start, then bracket start, 000, space, 0000, space, 000, codes close, bracket close, and enter. Let's add some formatting to this particular section. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select these headers and then go to home, increase the indent a bit. These I'll align to left. Just for the sake of better visibility, I'll remove the grid lines for now. I'll go to view, and from here I'll click this checkbox so that the grid lines are removed. Now you can check if the information coming is correct or not by selecting a different employee from here. Cool. Now that this is done, we have the last and the most important thing to do, which is inserting the image. Let's start doing that now. We'll first of all go back to the employee information tab and select the first cell with the image. Make sure to select the cell and not the image. Like here, this is the cell selection, but if you click over here, this is the image selection. In order to avoid any confusion, I would advise that you select a cell near to this image, like this, and then go to the cell using your arrow keys on the keyboard. Now copy the cell using Ctrl C on Windows or Command C on Mac. Now go back to the Identity Card tab and select a cell in the design area where you want to paste the image. Right click on the cell, go to paste special and then paste picture link. So now what you've done is that you pasted the picture as a link to the cell in the employee information tab. And it's not a separate image. If you delete the image from the employee info, let's say something like this, you'll see that the same thing happens over here as well. Or if you change the image or make a change in the image, the same thing will happen here in this tab as well. So logically, what you need to do now is that you need to look up the linked image to the selected ID. So let's define a named range. In order to do so, go to the Formulas tab in the ribbon, click on the Define Name option. This will open the new dialog box. Now add a name for the data range that you're about to make. Let's call it Photo. Here in this particular area, we will add a function for the range selection. Now please look at the function carefully. What we are going to do is that we are going to index the image column and then match them against the employee ID. So our function would be like equal to index bracket start. I'll go to the employee data tab without clicking anywhere and select the cells that have the photos like this, comma, match, bracket start, go back to the sheet with the identity card template. Then I'll select the cell which has the drop down for the employee ID, which is this one, comma. Now I need the entire range of employee IDs. So I'll go back to the employee data. I'll select the entire range for employee IDs like this, comma. I need to put a zero for exact match, bracket close and bracket close. And then I'll press OK. Now a new range has been created with the name photo. Next, what I need to do is that this linked image that I've added over here, I want to call this by the named range photo. So now what I'll do is that I'll click on this particular image, and here in the formula bar, you can see that it shows equal to employee data F2. I'll just remove this information, and after equal to, I'll put down photo. You can see that the named range is appearing here. Click on it and enter. Wow. This now links the image to the cell selected in the drop-down, and see how cool it is to have the correct image here. Now you can just select the image and adjust it as per the ID card space. Now one thing that you would have noticed here is that the image is looking too pixelated. The reason for it is that in our employee data, these images are also small in size. And these being linked images, they will just follow the original link. So what we're going to do is that we will just increase the size of the images in the employee data, and we can see that how it reflects better in the final identity card. So let me just try and resize these images. As soon as I increase the size of the images in employee data, you can see that in the identity card also, the images are coming sharper. Once you're done, give it a try by selecting various employees. You can also make sure that when you're doing the print setup, you only select this area as the printable area. And that's it guys, you're done. If you have the photos ready with you, the entire setup should not take you much time. And you can also try your hands at various designs. And that's the end of the video guys. Again, reminding you that a link to the template is in the description of the video. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to make sure that you're not missing out on any of the future interesting videos. And until next time, bye-bye.